Hello friends, welcome back. In this tutorial, we will study about extended transition function for NFP with empty transitions. First of all, we will study how we can find out the empty closure of a set of states. Now see. Suppose we have to find out the empty closure of a set of states, and that set has n states, q1, q2, q3, q4 up to qn. Then what will we do? We will find the empty closure of each state of the set individually, and then we will take union of all of them, right? So the empty closure of a set having n states, q1, q2, q3 up to qn, will be equal to empty closure of q1 union empty closure of q2 union empty closure of q3 union, so on up to empty closure of qn. It would be more clear after this example. Suppose there is an NFA with empty transitions. Now here Q0 is the initial state and Q3 is the final state. Now we have to find out the empty closure of this set of states. This set has three states, Q0, Q1 and Q2. So what will we do? We will find the empty closure of each state and take union of all of them. Now see, first we will find the empty closure of Q1. Then empty closure of Q2, then empty closure of Q0, and then we will take union of all of them, right? Empty closure of Q1 will be a set having four states. Now see here, empty closure of Q1 will contain Q1. Now see here, there is an empty transition to Q0, so Q0 will also be in empty closure of Q1. From Q0, there is an empty transition to Q3. From Q1 also there is an empty transition to Q2. So Q3, Q2, Q0 and Q1, they all will be in empty closure of Q1. Now see, empty closure of Q2. Empty closure of Q2 will be a set having only one state, Q2, because from Q2 there is no empty transition. Now see the empty closure of Q0. Empty closure of Q0 will be a set having two states, Q0 and Q3. Now see here, from Q0 there is an empty transition to Q3. So empty closure of Q0 will contain two states, Q0 and Q3. Now take Now after this, take the union of all these set of states. When we take union of these three sets, we will get a set having these states, Q0, Q1, Q2 and Q3. Now we will study about the extended transition function for NFA with empty transitions. For a single input symbol, extended transition function behaves same as normal transition function in case of DFA and NFA without empty transitions, but not in case of NFA with empty transitions. We can find out the output of extended transition function in case of NFA with empty transitions for present state Q and input symbol A. Right? How we can find out it? How we can find the output of extended transition function in case of NFA with empty transitions for present state Q and input symbol A? First of all, we will find the empty closure of state Q. Then we apply the input symbol A to the empty closure of state Q. After applying A to the empty closure of state Q, we will get a set of states. And then we will find the empty closure of that set of states, right? And that will be the output of this extended transition function for present state Q and input symbol A. Now it would be more clear after this example. Now see this NFA. In this NFA with empty transitions, we have to find out the output of extended transition function for present state Q0 and input symbol A. First of all, find the empty closure of present state Q0. Empty closure of present state Q0 will contain two states, Q0 and Q1. Now apply the input symbol A to this set of states Q0 and Q1. So first apply A to Q0, then apply A to Q1 and take union output. Now see here, there is no transition from state Q0 for input symbol A. Right? From Q1, there is a transition for input symbol A, that is to state Q2. So we will get a set having only one state, that is Q2, after applying the input symbol A to this set of states. Now again find the empty closure of Q2. Empty closure of Q2 contains two states, Q2 and Q3, right? So we will get a set of two states, Q2 and Q3. So the output of extended transition function for present state Q0 and input symbol A will be a set of two states, Q2 and Q3. Now, suppose this is an NFA with empty transitions. Now we have to find out if the present state of this NFA is A, and we apply a string of input symbols A, B, right? Then what would be the set of possible states in which this NFA can be after reading the string of input symbols A, B, after reading the string A, B from present state A? So for this, we need to find the output of extended transition function for state A and a string of input symbols AB. So first of all, find the empty closure of state A. Empty closure of state A will have two states, state A and state B. Now apply the first input symbol of this string, that is A, to this set of states. So apply input symbol A to this set of states having two states A and B. Now see, for state A, there is no transition for input symbol A. For B, there is a transition to state C for input symbol A, right? So when we apply A to this set of states, we will get a set having one state, right, as a result. And that set will contain only one state, that is C, right? Now take the empty closure of C. Empty closure of C will contain only one state, that is state C. Now apply second input symbol of the string, that is B, to this set of state. When we apply B to this set of state, right, C, there is only one transition from state C for input symbol B, that is to state D. So we will get a set having one state, that is set having one state, that is a set having state D, right? Now find the empty closure of D. Empty closure of D will have two states, state D and E, right? So the output of this extended transition function will be a set having two states, state D and state E. So it means when the machine is in present state A, right, when A is the current state of machine and it reads a string of input symbols AB, then the set of possible states in which this NFA with empty transitions can be will be a set having two states, D or E, right? Now see, if the output of extended transition function in case of NFA with empty transition for initial state and a string of some input symbols. Is a set having at least one final state of NFA, then that string will be accepted by that NFA, right? So here in this case, A is the initial state of this NFA, and the output of extended transition function for state A and a string of input symbols AB is a set having final state E. So this string AB will be accepted by this NFA.